Princey Beauty, or The Princess and the Pea and Prince Online. Once upon a time, a prince was growing up. The time for playing around had to stop. He needed to find a beautiful wife to become his princess and complete his life. He searched and searched around the world. He wanted to find his perfect girl. He went east and north and west, and even south to find the best. In the end, he was tired and so very sad. All of the girls he saw made him mad, because one was too boring and one too tall. One was annoying and one too small. Then one night, with rain, storm and more, all of a sudden, a knock on the door, and outside was standing a girl soaking wet, the most stunning girl the prince had ever met. She was a princess, at least so she said. They invited her in and gave her some bread. The prince was amazed, but the queen squeezed her eyes. Wasn't this girl just telling them lies? So the queen, she ordered a beautiful bed. "We need 100 mattresses and pillows," she said. And under it all, she laid a small little pea, almost impossible for the eye to see. They all said good night and went down to bed. But the moment the girl laid down her head, she felt so uncomfortable, she didn't close an eye. "I've turned all blue," she said with a sigh. "Oh, she's a real princess," the queen cried out. "Hooray, hooray," they all started to shout. "You will marry the prince and become the new queen. The most beautiful wedding we have ever seen." Once upon a time, a king, you might say. Oh no, and this is not the usual story about a wooden puppet with a nose that grows either. No, no, no. This actually might be the story about a complicated love. The one between the prince puzzled online and his computer, which he with love and affection called Constant Thought. Prince Puzzled Online was the only child of King Happy Online and Queen Carousel Chatting, and therefore the only heir of the kingdom Chatting Online. Prince Puzzled was lazy, very lazy. He was so lazy that he never got out of bed, not even to eat, to take a shower, to go to the toilet, or even to the barber. Thanks to the royal inventor, the great genius General Electrode Microchip, also just called Alex, Prince Puzzled had found a way to stay in bed and still be able to do any kind of everyday activity. But, Alex said to him every day, "I know you're a prince, but, you shouldn't exaggerate with all these technically advanced devices." Puzzled looked at him. Puzzled, because he didn't understand what those big words meant. Devise something and technical what? He was nodding to seem intelligent, but actually he couldn't wait for Alex to get out of the way so he could continue playing on his Princey Play, the PlayStation for princes. And remember that a computer isn't an intelligent instrument. It doesn't think. It doesn't know how to do things. You make it do things. Don't get used. Don't become a slave, Alex said. Puzzle nodded. And above all, use the fingers! This time Puzzle answered right away. What? No, not the fingers. Fantasy. Sometimes you should put your nose outside your room and the castle. Real life doesn't go on in a computer. Puzzle listened carefully, but he couldn't care less about Alex's advices. And typing on the keyboard of his constant thought, he was able to connect with the whole world and see lots of things without ever needing to get out of his room. Queen Carousel Chatting, the mother of Prince Puzzle, was very preoccupied about her son's destiny. "My dear Puzzle," she said one day, "you can't go on like this, closed inside your room."
"Why not?"
puzzled asked. I'm feeling well here. Why should I get out?
Well, Queen Carousel answered, you are a prince. One day, maybe not far from now, you will sit on the throne where the king your father, Happy and Lion, is sitting right now. You can't go on the throne without knowing the colours, the flavours, the sounds, the smells of the world.
Even staying right here, I can see and learn lots of things.
But that is not the same as living them, the queen insisted. And if you never get out of your room, how will you ever meet a princess, as you are supposed to? Doesn't Electrode ever talk to you about this?
Electrode uses a lot of different words. It's not like I always understand everything.
Prince Puzzle made a serious expression. He didn't say anything else, and he went back to playing his princey play. The queen panted and went out of her son's room, shaking her head disappointed. The next day, Carousel Chatting was still very anxious, so she decided to take a walk in the park to distract herself a little. While she was admiring the colours of a beautiful water lily recently opened just in the middle of the pond with Japanese fish, her mobile phone rang. It was Prince Puzzled. She answered.
You know what, Mom?
Said the piercing voice of the hare, who was appearing on the little screen on the Queen's phone, thanks to the webcam Puzzled had installed on his computer.
I've thought about what you've said. You're right. I have to find a princess.
The queen sighed in relief. Finally, Prince Puzzled would get out of his room. Finally, he would get married. He would become a king. He would get lots of little princes and princesses. And she would retire. Maybe. Or maybe she would travel. There were so many places in the world that she had only seen in television. Or maybe...
I made her identikit with Photoshop. Look!
Prince Puzzle said. And at that moment, on the screen of the Queen's mobile phone, a photo of a smiling young girl appeared.
What have you done?
Queen Carousel asked. She hadn't really understood, or maybe she was just hoping that she hadn't understood.
I've made her identikit with Photoshop. Look! Isn't it beautiful? I'm already in love,
Prince Puzzle said.
But this is just a creation of your fantasy, said the queen, trying to discourage him.
I just put into practice what Electrode suggested me to do,
Puzzle said.
But...
The queen couldn't find the words anymore.
But if she is just something created with your fantasy, she doesn't exist.
No, I'm sure she exists. I've dreamt about her, and now I'll surf around the world trying to find her,
Puzzle said.
Surf?
The queen's voice fainted in her throat. It is true that she wanted her son to get out of his room, but surfing? It could be dangerous.
My dear, she said preoccupied, couldn't you try to look for her a little closer to here? Getting out on the open sea could be dangerous and you don't have any experience in...
She wasn't able to finish the sentence.
But Mom, what did you understand? I'll surf on the internet, staying right here,
Puzzle said.
Surf? How?
The queen's voice trembled slightly.
On the internet!
But...
The queen was desperate.
I've already put out an advertisement on www.singleprincesses.com.
You did what?
Now I just have to wait a little. I'm sure that someone will answer my announcement,
Puzzle answered. The queen was very doubtful. But she didn't have any alternatives. To be sure, though, that this thing wouldn't go on forever, she put down a condition. Within a year, he had to marry a real princess in flesh and blood. Prince Puzzle accepted, convinced that he wouldn't spend a lot of time,
and caught up in his new project, he explored digital seas every day, looking for his princess. But even though his engagement was bountiful, he didn't seem to find her. In the meantime, the queen was getting busy. Not wanting to waste a minute, she organized some chat dates with the most desperate princesses in the kingdom, in the hope that sooner or later, Puzzled would get out of his room to meet them.
Dear, Princess Thumbelina Slimmily from Dietyland, why don't you talk to her? She is so long-limbed, the queen said. Well, long-limbed she was.
Even her profile, very thin and straight as a pole, but also very, very small. And if it hadn't been for the webcam that was their mean of communication, he wouldn't even have been able to see her.
Hello,
a piercing female voice said.
I'm Thumbelina Slimmily. I weigh very little and I'm very slim. I like microfood, water and salads that I prepare with my slender hands.
Interesting, the queen urged. All healthy things, don't you think, my dear?
Prince Puzzled nodded bored.
Sure, Mom, sure. Thus he greeted the princess with a vague smile and waved his hand. Maybe we could have dinner some evening.
Oh, no, I never eat in the evening. Then I feel all blown up.
Puzzled answered. So, lunch then?
Normally I skip lunch to have yoga lessons,
Thumbelina continued.
Puzzle said shortly. Then, see you around.
Oh, yes, yes, how nice,
Thumbelina Slimmily squeaked.
And then I'll tell you all about the healthy nourishment of...
The line died.
With a great positive spirit, the queen said, On the other line, we have the Princess of Gymnastikstan.
The Princess of Gymnastikstan was aerobic Cinderella, and she never stood still for a second, not even in front of the webcam.
I know that Prince Puzzled doesn't like to leave his room, but we can transform it into a gym. Then he can always do all the exercises necessary to improve his muscle tone, his lung capacity. He can run, step, bike.
That seems interesting, Queen Carousel said to her son. And to do all this, you wouldn't even have to leave the palace.
Sure, sure, Puzzle answered, and greeted the princess, who was doing sit-ups in the chat to make the most of the time.
Then, in the video conference, he met Princess Mermaid Melody from the Opera Ocean. To chat with the princess, she had installed a webcam on the edge of a bathtub. But the chat ended briefly, because when she answered the call, she did it with a YES! So loud that the screen of the prince splintered.
The prince wasn't satisfied at all with the dates organized by his mother, and nostalgically he watched the picture he had created some time ago with his photo show program. Besides, he had very little time left. Waiting for his dream princess to appear, almost 12 months had gone by. Actually, to be exact, the year would expire at midnight the very next day. His princess wasn't to be found, and he had no other choice than to choose between aerobic Cinderella, Thumbelina Slimmily, and the Mermaid Melody. Aerobic Cinderella, Thumbelina Slimmily, Melody, who to choose? One was too small and skinny, one too much in shape and active, the last was too piercing, and the idea of spending all of the time in an aquarium wasn't very enthusiastic. Thumberobic, Aerolina, Melarella. The prince was getting confused. He couldn't control the tiredness, and outside a storm was raging. It was drumming, wheezing, the clouds were rolling, lights were flashing, and thunderbolts exploding in the air. It was dark night. He was thinking, and he was about to collapse, when he seemed to hear someone knocking on the main door of the castle.
Maybe he was wrong. Maybe it was only a thunder. He listened carefully. It was knocking again. No answer. It seemed as everybody in the castle was sound asleep. He made a decision. He lifted up the video house phone in his room, and that was the moment he saw her. It was her. It was really her. The same princess that he had dreamt about and then created with Photoshop. The exact same girl. Only a little soaked. But the most important thing was that he was still in time. And at this point, Postle did something he hadn't done for a long time. He left his room and he ran down to open the door. Queen Carousel met her son on the stairs. She had also got up to see who had knocked on the door in such a horrible night.
"Postled!" the queen screamed. "You have left your room!"
Her voice was unbelieving.
"It's her! She's here! It's her!"
the prince answered, running down the long stairs. He opened the door. The girl was soaking wet from head till toe, as if she fully clothed had fallen into the bathtub of Cindelina or Thalady or Melody or whatever the singing mermaid was called. When they entered the castle, the girl was dripping so bad that in seconds the hall flooded.
"Hurry up! We need buckets!"
Queen Carousel ordered, and immediately the servants cleaned up everything. They dried the floor and even brought a big hairdryer so the girl could dry her hair.
"Good evening. I'm sorry about the time. I wanted to arrive tomorrow with the sun, but all the hotels are closed and I couldn't find anywhere to sleep, not even paying in gold," the girl said.
Postled was smiling, and for once he wasn't puzzled at all. He was sure it was her.
"Let me present myself. My name is Princey Beauty. I come from the kingdom Peace Love. I found this ad on the internet. I'm looking for a princess ready to move into a castle with all possible comforts, etc., etc. So, if you're looking for a real princess, here I am," the girl said.
Yes, sure, sure," said the queen, who didn't trust the girl whatsoever.
Actually, she would most certainly have put the girl back out on the street if it hadn't been for the fact that her being there had brought Postle out of his room.
So she decided to keep her for the night. She made her servants prepare the guest room for the girl, but to make sure that Princey Beauty wasn't a swindler, she hid a very small pea-shaped microphone under 12 mattresses. When the young girl went to bed, the queen went into her own bedroom, closed the door, put on her headphones, and started listening. If Princey Beauty said anything compromising, she, the queen, would be the first to know, and she would kick her out of the castle for good. Postle went to sleep very happy that night. He didn't have to choose between aerobic cinder somethings, Thumbelina Margarine or Melense or whatever their names were. And he slept like a baby until morning. The queen fell asleep with her headphones on, but she didn't hear a word. The next morning, Princey Beauty of the Kingdom Peace Love hadn't closed an eye all night. So that very morning, she searched between the mattresses and found a strange, green, pea-shaped object. But it wasn't a pea. She dismounted it and discovered that it was some kind of a small microphone. Serious and sleepless, she left her room with that thing in her hand, determined to get an explanation. Queen Carousel was making breakfast for Postle, who after having left his room seemed completely changed, when Princey Beauty showed up. "And this," Princey Beauty said, putting the pea microphone under the queen's nose.
"Where did you find that, my dear?"
the queen answered peacefully.
"Mom," Postle started speaking, but his mom gave him a sign to stop.
"I found it under the 12 mattresses on which I was trying to sleep. What was it doing under there? This is a mini micro microphone of the 7th generation. It has a 30-meter range. It can be connected via Bluetooth to 3 computers at the same time, and it...
The Queen and Puzzle were astonished.
Only a worthy princess with a real title would be able to find that microphone under 12 mattresses, the Queen exclaimed.
Only an expert in electronics and computer science would be able to know all this, Puzzle exclaimed.
There were no doubts that she was the one. The Queen stood up solemnly.
My dear, you have brilliantly passed the test. The fact that you found this microphone at the size of a pea under 12 mattresses is the proof.
We have the princess,
Puzzle and Carousel said with one voice, looking at each other with big smiles. There was no need to wait until midnight to decide.
Puzzle emailed the mermaid Melody, Thumbelina Slimmerly and Aerobic Cinderella, inviting them to the wedding. From that day on, they lived happily ever after, and Puzzle's computer was no longer his constant thought. Actually, he discovered that seeing, feeling, touching, listening, tasting, and smelling are not the same as looking at pictures on a screen. You need to try to believe.